I am here now with Laila Benitez, mayor of Mountain Village. Laila,
hi,
welcome.
Peter.
Thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. I've been wanting to catch up with you actually all summer, so I'm glad we're getting you in the last summer episode, the last official summer episode. We may try to squeeze one more in, but...
Well, thanks for having me. I'm glad this worked out.
Yeah. Before we get into the sort of juicy business of being mayor of Mountain Village, I just wanted to ask you about your background a little bit, how you came to Mountain Village, when that was, and why that was.
Yeah. I think I share the same story as a lot of people. I came here because the man I love brought me here on my first vacation with him.
And that would be Anton Benitez.
That's Anton Benitez.
Who heads up Telluride Mountain Village Owners Association.
Yeah. So Anton and his family have been here for decades, and they have a place up here, and he brought me here in 97, and I adored him, but I looked around and I thought, you know, if this doesn't work out with him, I still need to remember how to get back here.
This is the end of the world.
This is home, yeah. And it was just this, I was just mesmerized from the beginning.
Oh, so you're saying you were captivated right away. I was
right
thinking you
away.
Were thinking to yourself, this is the middle of nowhere. What am I going to do here if this doesn't work out?
No, I grew up in Los Angeles.
Okay.
I didn't know places like this existed.
Okay.
And it was, I mean, it was an immediate reaction. Tears rolling down my cheeks. Kodo was on. They were playing Sir Mix-a-Lot. And I remember every second of it. And it was like, I've got to find a way back here no matter what.
Right.
And that's what we did. You know, we came back. We were working, and we still managed to come back three or four times. Anytime we had a few days off, we even took a position in Colorado Springs just because it was that much closer to being here. And then, you know, eventually, 8 years ago, we were both working in the medical device industry, and we were traveling a lot and not seeing each other. By then, we were married. We'd gotten married here. And we thought, okay, well, where are we happiest? And it was, oh, well, that's a no-brainer.
Mm.
And I was like, well, but that's, we can't do that.
Right. That's a resort. That's a vacation place.
Yeah. Who picks up and moves to Telluride? Like, that's something maybe you do if you're lucky when you retire or if you're lucky enough to be born here. And I don't know, it was one of those crazy moments where we talked each other into it. And sure enough, we moved here.
So you came without really knowing what you were going to do?
Exactly.
Oh, that's cool.
We were.
I did the same thing.
Yeah. It was one of those things where it's like, you know what? Life is short. And we can wait to be happy when we're 60, or we can try and be happy, you know, at that point we were in our 30s. That's long gone now. But we decided to make the jump, and we did. And the one thing that we promised each other is when we move here, we want to be, you know, growing up in big cities, you don't have an opportunity to really be a part of a community.
Right.
And we thought, if we do it, we want to really be a part of the community. So no moving to Telluride and just...
Right.
Making the same habits of getting so involved with our careers or whatnot. We wanted to make this a complete lifestyle change.
Well, if I may say it, there's no way to imagine you or Anton being more involved than you are with the community. And now you're actually the mayor of Mountain Village. So I want to talk a little bit about that, how it's been. That happened when exactly?
That was in July of last year.
July 2017, that's
right.
What I thought. So you've had just over a year.
Yeah.
And I wanted to ask you just about, first of all, how much of a change that's represented in your life, because now you're even more than ever in the public eye. And just a little bit of generally about the experience of being mayor, and then we can get into some of the specifics of things you've been dealing with in Mountain Village.
Yeah, it was a big change. Up until then, I had a small event business and put on the Integrative Wellness Summit and other things like the Kids Zone that I was really proud of. But once I was chosen as mayor, it became apparent that, you know, it's going to be hard to have that same career and be as objective as possible with everything that comes in front of a mayor. So I put my business on hold, and being mayor has been a full-time job now.
I can imagine.
Yeah.
And so do you feel pressure in that position? Because there's a lot of scrutiny, and obviously... Like most communities, but especially rural mountain resort towns, there's a certain divide in terms of the politics and people's preferences and needs and urgencies. So, do you feel pressure as mayor, or is it pretty chill?
I would say, well, I wouldn't use the word chill, but I would say, you know, I'm surrounded by a phenomenal team on town council. We are all working in this together. So, that makes it infinitely easier. I can't imagine a stronger team at Town Hall with everyone that's working there, led by Kim Montgomery, our town manager. So that takes a lot of the pressure off. You're surrounded by great people, and we all have the same goal. Mm-hmm. You know, we may have different ideas about how to get there on a given day, but there is that strong shared sense of purpose. So,
and where would you say the majority of your time is concentrated? I mean, this summer has been a little bit of an anomaly, I guess, with fire and water and evacuation concerns. Yeah. But ongoing, there's the issue of affordable housing and density and finances, the trail system, the town hall area, development, all those things. I mean, a lot of different things that are all sort of priority items. Where do you think you spend the majority of your time as mayor? Which of those sort of areas, or is it spread out pretty evenly?
I would say it's spread out pretty evenly because they all do impact one another. So, you know, we have the town hall sub area project underway right now. And Natalie Binder and Bruce McIntyre are council representatives there. And, you know, they're looking at everything in that town hall area, from creating a park to realigning the road to affordable housing. Mm-hmm. And is there a way that we can get in more childcare? And so many of these projects are very similar to that, where you're not making one choice. These projects, they all impact one another. Mm-hmm. And everything needs to be analyzed from a financial point of view, as well as impact. And do you have too much density in one spot? And what can you do to make the transition not so jarring to the community as possible? And I think that's a really good example of how it's all integrated together, mm-hmm. these issues.
And do you feel like you're sort of well-suited for the job? Do you think your background has helped contribute to your success as mayor? Or is there something you wish you had in your sort of quiver coming into it that you didn't?
Media training would have been nice.
It's on the job training right here, right
exactly.
now.
Exactly. No. You know, I came from the medical device industry, and I was in clinical research, and I was in charge of a team of engineers and, you know, animal scientists and clinicians. And I think that that's given me a great opportunity to learn how to work with a multifaceted team and to bring it all together and take everyone's strengths and really optimize it. And at the same time, find out, okay, when can I give a little more in any one given direction to bolster the team? Right. So well, it's worked out well.
One of the things I've always heard about good management is the key is to surround yourself by people who are as or more smart and competent than you are.
Absolutely.
And I heard from Catherine Warren, just a little unknown secret about you, that you speak Farsi.
I do. My mother's Iranian. I'm first generation here on that side, and my father is American.
Right.
So, yeah, I grew up speaking Farsi, and we had a little small Iranian community there. So
that's so cool.
That's how I grew up.
Really something that every small town mayor should have in their quiver of talents.
Absolutely, especially in an area like Telluride. It comes in so handy.
Thank you very much, Laila, for being here. It's been a real pleasure to catch up with you. Wish you continuing success as mayor of Mountain Village, and we'll have you on again.
Thank you.
Sound good?
It sounds great. Thank you.